I will briefly introduce Professor János Sipos. He is a senior ethnomusicologist in the Folk Music Research Group of the Hungarian Academy of Sciences, Institute for Musicology. He specializes in Turkic, the Turkic element in Hungarian, and he'll the Hungarian culture, and he will explain that. He speaks Turkish fluently and is acquainted with some other Turkic languages. His wife is a Turkic language specialist, linguist, and they've traveled together. And she teaches linguistics at the Peter Pozmány University, Catholic University in Budapest. Just to tell you why his coming here is important, a lot of us music educators in the United States are adapting the Hungarian music education system and philosophy to American music education, which means we are researching our English language-based, our Spanish language-based, and our Native American-based folk songs. The Hungarians have discovered through the leadership of Béla Bartók and Zoltán Kodály that the folk song is the ideal starting place for nationwide music education, and that most classical music forms have developed out of the true authentic folk song, which has strong linguistic and cultural implications. You should know that the entire Provo School District, all of the elementary schools, have this style of a music specialist, as a fully paid salaried professional in them as a result of our BYU music education outreach. And I administer that program and write the curriculum. So János and I have been on the Navajo Reservation and actually in three states, Utah, Arizona, and New Mexico in this last week collecting some songs. And he now is a visiting Fulbright research scholar at UCLA. And so please welcome with me János Sipos.
Thank you for coming. So I was introduced, but unfortunately my English is not as good as it should be. So I will read my part of my presentation and I will explain some part of it, so we will see. Hungarian ethnomusicologists have been making efforts for long years to draw the musical mapping of a huge area. This area is in Asia where Turkic and Mongolian peoples live. Now I have to go to the map.
I don't really know if you are familiar with the map of Middle Asia, Central Asia. So this is China, and here is Inner Mongolia. That's Inner Mongolia, but it's inner for them. There are lots of Mongolia and other people there with similar. Remember that at the western West Mongolia there are Kazakh people. It's a kind of Turkey Kipchak. They speak a special Turkic language. Actually, more than widespread language, Kipchak. Then Kazakhstan is a huge country, not almost as large as Europe. As the rest of the world. So please remember that here. I will refer to Volga Kamor region, two rivers, Volga and Kamor rivers. They live Finno-Ugrian and Turkic people. So please remember that Chuvash, Turkic people, Tatars, and Bashkir. Yeah. They speak somehow similar languages as Kazakh and Kyrgyz people. They speak Kipchak. Then you probably heard of Bronze where Iran is, and Iraq is. Azerbaijan is this area, the southern slopes of the Caucasus mountain. So please remember Azerbaijan too, Turkey, and the European part of Turkey is Thrace. So I prefer these things. And Hungary.
You could ask the question, what business do Hungarian ethnomusicologists have in Turkey, in the Caucasus, and in the Kazakh steppe? Let us remember a beautiful wording by the great Hungarian musicologist Bence Szabolcsi. Hungarian music are the outermost branch leaning from the age-old tree of the great Asian musical culture, rooted in the souls of a variety of peoples living from China through Central Asia to the Black Sea. While the languages of different Turkic peoples have been subjected to thorough comparative analysis, only the first few steps have been taken in the comparative research of their music. Several Hungarian scholars search for traces of the origin of the Hungarians in Asia. Since the culture of the Hungarian settling in the Carpathian Basin displayed strong Turkic influences, it is quite justified to presume that Hungarian folk music also incorporated significant Turkic effects or layers. It is no wonder that researching the Eastern elements in Hungarian folk music has great traditions. Very little is known for sure about the dances or songs of the Hungarians entering the Carpathian Basin. No written record survives. Historical researches may help create grounds for hypotheses, and literature might have a few allusions, but these are too meager to draw essential musical information or notated music from. The only source we have to fall back upon is living folk music and the old music collections, which are, of course, quite new in a historical sense. However, systematic and cautious comparison of tunes may help date some styles. It is impossible to declare that items of a musical style deemed 1,000 years old were identical with their contemporary forms. But wherever possible, we compared old 400 years old notes with contemporary folk music data and have found remarkable conversation of tradition in the essential features. We have a relatively clear picture of the Hungarian folk music, its main types and styles, even if there might be some controversy among scholars in minor issues. It is therefore known the correspondence of what kind of musical forms are to be searched for in the folk music of other people. Comparison with other folk music began over 90 years ago with the comprehensive conception of a great scholar. Just a few months after having begun the systematic collection and study of Hungarian folk songs, Béla Bartók started to explore the Slovak, it's one of our neighboring country, and later the Romanian musical traditions in the Carpathian Basin. He was convinced that only in the thorough knowledge of the folk music of neighboring peoples could it be established what was specifically Hungarian, what was common or different in the traditions of different ethnic groups. At the same time, he showed keen interest in the music of ethnicities. In 1913, he went to North Africa, to the oasis around Biskra, to study the music of the Arabs there. In 1990, he collected Carpatho-Ukrainian folk songs in Upper Hungary. Although after the First World War, he stopped collecting folk songs, this theme preoccupied him later on as well, and he wanted to extend the area of research toward the Turkic peoples. As he put it, I first searched for Finno-Ugrian Turkic similarities somewhere around the peoples living by the Volga, and then started from there in the direction of Turkey. In 1936, Bartok was invited to Turkey to hold lectures in Ankara, have concerts with the Ankara Orchestra, and carry on a modern research work in an appropriately chosen Turkish village. They had little time, 10 days, for research. They chose a place around Osmaniye, near the southern seashore of Turkey. It was one of the winter boats of the nomadic Turkmen Yörük tribes. The hypothesis was that people who had preserved their ancient migrating wave of life also adhered more closely to their old musical stock than sedentary population. Bartok systematized the collected tunes and said, if we compare these characteristics with those of the old Hungarian melodies with 8-syllabic sections, we see that they are literally identical. After Bartok's Turkish expedition, there came a 20-year-long break in collecting, giving way to writing of monumental theoretical studies. Studying the music of Asia could begin again when, upon Zoltán Kodály's intervention, an agreement between the Soviet and Hungarian Academies of Sciences provided for the possibility of two Hungarian researchers going to the Central Volga region. László Vikár and Gábor Berecki collected among Finno-Ugrian and Turkic ethnic groups living here. Their work is providing reliable information about the folk music layers in a vast area populated by many nations. Their collected work has revealed that a fifth shifting style resembling a Hungarian folk music stratum can be found in an area some 50 miles in diameter among both Cseremis and Csuvas. Can we listen to the CD, please? So let us listen to two melodies, two Hungarian melodies of this fifth shifting style. These melodies are characterized by the second part of the melody is a fifth lower than the first part. And usually they move on, they use pentatonic scales. The first example is pentatonic, but somehow strange, you will hear it. So, and please try to find out what kind of structure these melodies have. I'm interested if you can find out the structure, the motivic construction of the melodies. The first and second track, please. Oh, thank you very much. So, if you listen carefully, this melody was built only for two motifs. Two motifs. And also if can I use a solmization system or?
They've got to learn something. Just go ahead.
Yeah. This is the motif, the basic motif. That the is variant, so the same. Long here, maybe the second. So the first motif, and the fifth lower. So this melody is built from two motifs. Two small motifs. And let us listen to the second melody, please. Track two.
Oh,
So that this is a typical, one of the typical Hungarian melody styles. It is descending, pentatonic, and fifth shifting. And, what is very important, beat and what ifs. So if we have enough time, I don't know, because we might run out of time, But I made some research on Dakota people, Dakota Indians. Bela Droz made a very extensive research in 1939 in Pinewood Reservation.
Montana.
Yeah, and collected more than 1,000 songs. I transcribed 350 songs, analyzed them, and compared, and I found a similar layer to this musical style. But what does it mean? So it's another question. Anyhow, we can say that there are similar styles, and actually we can find this special pentatonic, descending pentatonic entire shift styles in Mongolia, in the Cherkis, the Volga Kamar region, and in Tatar people have somehow similar music, so it's a wonder that they don't have this style. So their music is descending, pentatonic, and motivic, and even they don't have this formation. But I have to say that I make contemporary research. I don't know what does it mean. We don't know what was this music like 1,000 years ago. But so we make small steps researching the musical styles existing in the world. Okay. The fieldwork among Turkic people restarted in 1987 with my expeditions in Turkey. If we want to know the most important musical relations, we need well-arranged material. However, while famous scholars analyze the Hungarian folk music, there is no comprehensive analysis about Turkish folk music. It was obvious that before comparing the Hungarian and the Turkish material, the Pathfinder work of analyzing and classifying the Turkish folk songs waits for me. As a result of my research, I published four books about Anatolian folk music. Anatolian, I mean Turkish. According to the evidence, the common Turkish and Hungarian layers are more significant than we had suspected. It turned out that there exist at least two more old Hungarian and Turkish melody layers which show very significant musical relationship. One of the important discoveries was that the most general form of the Turkish and Hungarian lament are essentially the same. This is the more important as the lament is a very old genre which usually resists the process of changing. I involved the songs of other people into the analysis, putting the Hungarian-Anatolian similarities into a larger context. Now, I cannot speak about my four books. It would be out of time, but let us listen to a so-called Hungarian psalmodic melody and its Turkish parallel. We try to find musical styles. And the psalmodic style has moves on Mireto or EDC, the melody. This is the center of the melody. And at the end, it can end on A. You can hear an exam, but it is only an exam, so a central, typical characteristic is an exam. But this style involves hundreds and hundreds of melodies. Here's the track 3 and 4. We will listen a Hungarian and a Turkish melody. This is the Hungarian one. Because there live other Turkish-speaking people between these areas, it seemed a logical step to extend the research to an even larger area. We know that at the western side of the huge Turkic-speaking area, there live the Chuvash, Tatar, Bashkir, Kazakh, Turkmen, Azeris, and Anatolian Turks, if we enumerate them from north to the south. At present, I make research work on this huge area and sometimes even more east. One of my main goals is to join the Volga-Kama area with Turkey and make the musical mapping of this huge area. Besides Turkey, where I have been making research since 1897, I led expeditions to Thrace, this European part of Turkey, Azerbaijan, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Mongolia, and I have collected folk songs from the Karachay people living in the Caucasus and Turkey. Let me say now a few words about some of my books based on this research. The academic publishing house Budapest published my book Kazakh Folk Songs from the Two Ends of the Steppe in 201. This volume is to afford a glimpse to the folk music of two Kazakh ethnic groups living some 200 miles apart. The Mongolian Kazakhs, if you remember, and other Kazakh people who moved to Turkmenistan and then moved back to southwest Kazakhstan in recent decades. Considering the huge territory of Kazakhstan and the complexity of the formation of the Kazakh nation, it was not impossible to have a presentiment that we will meet different musical styles in the areas inhabited by Kazakh people. And indeed, while the Kazakh language shows surprising homogeneity, the musical divergences are significant. While the pentatonic melodies of the Mongolian Kazakhs belong to the pentatonic world of Chinese, Mongolian, Tatar, and some Hungarian melodies, the melodies of southwestern Kazakhstan is near to the diatonic world of Turkey. According to Anatolian, Thracian, Kazakh, Kyrgyz, Turkmen, Tatar, Bashkir, and Karachay material at hand, there is a significant area difference here. The pentatonic zone part of Malaysia, you cannot find. there is an interesting area difference in music too. Let us listen now to a melody from South Kazakhstan, which belongs to the same musical layer Bartok was so happy to find during his Anatolian research. Track 6, please. No, next. Thank you very much. That's the next. My book, Azeri Folk Songs at the Fountainhead of Music, is a result of my researches in Azerbaijan. The Azeri language is a very close variant of the language people speak in Turkey, but the two populations have different history and different process of formation. It seemed instructive to examine the relation of the two of the Azeri folk songs to the folk music of other Turkic people and that of the Hungarian. In the simple yet so complete world of the Azeri folk music, there live elemental melody styles that may be traced back to the old history of the music. This folk music represents a unique color inside the folk music of Turkic people. It differs significantly from the folk music of the neighboring people and from that of the Turkic people living far from here. The music of Iranian people who played an important role in the formation of Azeri people probably had a great effect on the formation of the Azeri folk music too. Let us listen to a so-called Uzun Hava, or long song melody, Bayati, track 7, please. While listening to this example, we can realize how expressive a melody of only a few tones may be. This music is really different from the descending pentatonic melodies the Dakota Nation love. This is a Dakota, beginning of a Dakota song. We will listen, yeah.
Were those real bird sounds?
I recorded those. I was recorded by myself outside. Bird, yes, bird, not people, not a human. it's wonderful. So, at present, I lead 3 projects with the backing of Hungarian Academy of Sciences and the British Royal Academy. I think that I will not have time to say too much about this project. I will shortly introduce them. So, one is the musical life of the Karachay people. The northern, if you remember, the Caucasus Mountain, the northern slopes of the Caucasus Mountain are an important place for the Hungarians because before going to the Carpathian Basin, we, where we live now, our ancestors lived here in the frame of the Khazar Empire. This is the one research I'm conducting now, I'm leading now. Another, a comparative analysis of the music of 3 Kyrgyz styles. There are books about the music of Kazakhs, but there is no music book. You cannot find book about the music of Kyrgyz. Though it's interesting, you have to be careful because these two names are mixed all the time. So Kazakh. Okay, so there I chose the three different areas and collected more than 1,000 songs. It's very, very slow. The Ad Bashi here, and Isik Girl, and Cengiz Aytmatov, who is a famous writer, and he has a Nobel Prize, and he wrote songs near the Chinese border, because during the Soviet period, lots of Kazakh escaped to China, and they some returned. The other part you can find Kazakh influence, and so this is the second, and the third is the religious and folk songs of the Bektashi people in Western Turkey, Thrace, in the European part of Turkey. Till now, I made 5 expeditions among the Bektashi. They called themselves Bektashi because the name of their prophet was Haji Bektash. And the Bektashi people living in the European part of Turkey, I collected more than 1,000 songs there too with my wife. There are several books about this religious community. We can read the text of their songs, but there is no comprehensive study about their music. And that's very typical concerning the Turkic people. So it's very good to make research there, because in many areas you are the first. If we have time, we can look at the video. Sure. On the video you will see an example of their religious dance, Sema. His name is Sema. Can we?
Do you want to see it now?
Yeah, yeah. Njolc. Yeah. Akkor nem. Jó, so time is limited, then we cannot. Okay, if I have 10 minutes left, then I try to summarize the... Okay. So... You may ask, why does a Hungarian ethnomusicologist examine the folk music of American Indians? Since Bruno Nettl said as early as the beginning of the 20th century that during the first half of the 20th century, Aboriginal North America has become the continent whose music has been the most extensively studied and best known. This is probably true even today. However, there are differences in methods and questions, and I might show you some example of this in my presentation. As I've told you, I'm a Fulbright research professor at the UCLA, and the UCLA has the Rhodes collection with lots of Dakota melodies. So I transcribed them and analyzed. Our method is a little bit different from our colleague used here in the United States. So we concentrate on transcribing melodies and analyzing. And here, the American colleagues concentrate on more on the circumstances, I would say, on the social, cultural aspects. I won't say about the rhythm, though it might be interesting. May I use the blackboard, please? So if we want to find out if there are any commonly among the Hungarian and the Dakota music, then we have to classify these musics. But the Hungarian music is classified. So I would say we have a children's songs type. It moves the central melody of this style, musical style is something like this, mi re do re mi re do re mi re do re mi re do, turning around D and then using only a tripod. Children's songs, Mia Lennon style. It's a rough map. So Lennon style, the basic form of the Hungarian Lennon. The Hungarian Lennon has a small form, two sections. The first section is moving from descending from G to D, and the second from F to C. So, for example, this is the basic melody. But these are styles. I say only the one melody by which you can characterize the side, the central melody. Then, so you can see that so we have a psalmodic style. In Christian and Jewish religious music, there are similar melodies. Moving on melody style, so it would take at least 1 hour to present it in detail. But you can have a picture. For example, do re mi, the first section. Or a longer variant. Same melody, but the second is 12 syllable, the first is 6. And we have a pentatonic descending melody styles too, and other musical styles too. So these styles are different from each other as a musical style. And inside the pentatonic descending melodic styles, there are fifth shifting pentatonic descending melodic style. Then I analyze the Dakota folk music. I found out that it's the best way to separate the melodies having a small range. So we have melodies, the Dakotas have, and now I discuss only the A pentatonic, La pentatonic melodies of the Dakotas, because the majority of the Hungarian folk songs so now I choose only the A pentatonic melodies. And I think that we might divide the Dakota folk songs into three categories. The first have a small range. Some, I would say that DCA. DCA, we will have some examples. The second is characterized by a descent from the octave. And the third have a range larger than an octave. And it's interesting, these central styles characterized by descent from the octave is a larger one. It's almost, I would say, 80%. it's very homogeneous, somehow. And the two other opposite sides are not homogeneous at all. So let's listen to a story song, which recites on only two notes before descending to the tonic. It's track 17. We don't know the number. We don't have the number on the screen. I will help you if I can. I listen to them. We have a handout. It's okay. This is good. This one is good. But it's not the same. But it's a lullaby, moving on three tones and sometimes reaching the A. We hear that these were two examples of the small range, and they are totally different. So in 2 minutes, in 1 minute. So the summary is that there are large central style, and you can find similarities with the Hungarian style. And it's a little example of our methods, very to dividing the musical style into the music into styles and comparing the styles. So unfortunately, the time is limited. Oh, thank you very much.